Hello everyone. So we are here with a new problem, which is a median of two sorted arrays of different size. So in this problem, what we have to do, we have two arrays and these two arrays have different size and we have to find the median. So what is median here? Median means if we have two arrays, array 1 and array 2, after sorting this array, we have 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 18, and 20. So what is median? So if you see the size of the array, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 is the size of array, and if we divided it by 2, which is 5. So you can see there are 4 elements at that side. Okay. And there are 4 elements at that side. So the median is these two elements. So the median is actually those elements which divides the array into two equal halves. Okay. And here you can see one thing from where we derive our concept. Whatever the median we have, to its left, everything is smaller than its right. So the first thing that we have to think of conceptual thing is wherever we have our median, okay, the left part is the minimum one, and wherever we have our median, the right part is nothing but the right part contains all the maximum value. Okay, this is the first observation we can think of. See, the brute force, everyone knows about that. We have to take these two elements, we have to sort this, and after sorting we can simply find the median by like the this array, this sorted array has length 10, and when we divide it by 2 we have 5, and in the case of even, the minimum, the two elements in the median is our answer. Okay, so if our array is even, and at that case we have two elements and we have to add it, like in that case the median is 6 plus 7 by 2, which is nothing but 13 by 2, which is nothing but 6.5. So this 6.5 is nothing but this is our median. Okay. Now that brute force having a time complexity of big O of n plus m, in order to traverse these two arrays and sort them like that, and the space complexity is again the big O of n plus m, because we are using an extra space to store that. Okay. Now the thing is, we get our concept is that we have to find a place. In that place, whatever present in the left is less than to its right. Okay, so what we do in order to solve this problem, so the simple thing that we do in order to solve this problem is, we have these two arrays, okay, and we want a median, okay, and in its left and in its right the element should be equal. So another observation is, the element which is present at the left should be equal to the element present at the right. Okay, so we have three observations: the element in the left and the element in the right should be equal, and the another thing is the left part should be less than the right part. Okay, so what we do in that condition, we simply work with that logic. So we have these two arrays, as you can see, 1, 5, 8, 10, 18, 20 and 2367, and these two array is sorted in itself. Now what I can do, can I do something like that, like from the array 1 we take the half of the element to be to the left. What I mean by this, understand, as you can see there, we take these two arrays sorted, and when we find a median, so sum of the elements, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 5, 1 and 5 is from the first array, and 2 and 3 is from the secondary. Similarly, in that case, the 10 and 20 and 18 from the first array, and the remaining thing is everything in the right side from the array 1. Okay. So it is clear that if we try to find a median, so in that case, in the left part, the elements in the left part can be from array 1 or array 2, okay, and in the right part, the element can be from array 1 or array 2. So these are the two things that we have to take care of. Okay, so what I try to do now, you can see this array 1 has a size of 6, okay, and if we divided it by 2, we have 3. So let's suppose we want a median. Okay, so we want a median. So let me take a color. So let's suppose this is the line which divides these two arrays. Okay, on the basis of, like, in that part we have the left elements, in that part we have the right elements. Okay, so what I do, I simply did one thing. In the first array, how many elements we have? 6. Divided it by 2, we get 3. So the first 3 elements is is the part of this left part. Okay, so we are taking the part, so we are taking it as a part. So we have 1 5 and 8. Okay, so this 1 5 8 is what? This 1 5 8 is a part. Okay, now how many elements in total we have? We have total 10 elements. Okay, and in that half part we have 5 elements, but I am taking these 3 elements. Now from the remaining second array, how many elements we can take? We can take only 2 elements, because we need 5 elements in this part, so 3 should be taken. Now we have to take 2 elements, so simply we can take the 2 elements, which is 2 and 3. So we have 2 and 3, and in this part we have 18 and we have 20, and in that part we have something 6 and 7, and in that part we have 10 as well. So you can see in this left part we have 5 elements, and in this right part we have 5 elements. Now the problem is here. The problem is that one is a right partition. Let's understand this. So we know very well that this much part, okay, is come from array 1, this much part is come from array 2, okay, and this much part is come from array 1, and this much part is come from array 2. It is obvious that this 8 should be less than whatever present to that one, okay, and this 3 should be less than, or this 2, 3 should be less than whatever present in that one, because they are belonging to the same array and the array is already sorted. The main thing here, the another conceptual thing that I want to add is cross check. So what is cross check? Cross check is if the element which is at that position, if it is less than the element at that position, because we want everything means every element present at this side should be less than that. Okay, so why we cross check? We cross check these two because this one is equal and we know it. Okay, and we know that this much part is sorted, this much part is sorted, this much part is sorted, and this much part is sorted. So in cross check we simply check if the last element of array 1, okay, is less than the last element of array 2. It means we can combine this, and this element 158 should less than that, and if this element is less than that, then it is obvious that it is already sorted. So in that case, what we do now, this is the case of even number. In that case, what we do, we simply took the maximum elements from this head. Why maximum? Because, you know, let's suppose, as you can see there, when we sort this, which element we take? So if let's suppose this is the partition, something, right? So from this part, we take the maximum. So 1 to 6, the maximum is 6. And from 7 to 20, the minimum is 7. Similarly, from in case of even numbers, the maximum one is this, and the minimum one is these two. So whatever the minimum and whatever the maximum, we just add it and divided it by 2. Now in that case, you can see the 8 is not less than 6. So what we have to do? So the concept is, if this check that we do, that the 8 should be less than that. So in order to understand it, let's write there. So we for now what we create, simply the first thing we create is, we create is partition. And how the partition is created? Let's suppose the first partition for the array 1 is cut 1, let's suppose, or whatever the name you have, you can take. So what we did in that case, so whatever the size of our, let's suppose n1 is the size of array 1, so we take this. So not like that, we take our low as 0 and we take our high as the size of the first array, okay? And what we do, you know very well, we simply add this 0 plus n1 and then we divided it by 2. So this is our cut 1, okay? So this is our cut 1. In that case, you can see the size is 6 and 6 by 2 is 3. So 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So we make a cut at this position. How we made a cut, let's understand after that. So the another cut is, which is a cut 2, in order to cut the second one. So let's suppose from there, we are getting 3 elements, and in total, the size of first array is n1, the size of second array is n2, and if we divided it by 2, eventually we get 10, and we get 5, okay? It means that in that partition, this left part contains the 5 element and this right part contains the 5 element. So the 3 is already considered. So how many elements we have to take, which is 5 minus 3, which is 2. So for that part, how much elements we have to take? 2. So 2 from the second array and 3 from the first array. In this way we take this. Now we want to make this partition. How we can do that? Simple. We have to create this one partition, we have to create this one, we have to create this one, we have to create this one. Let's name it. This one is, let's suppose, left 1 partition. This one is, let's suppose, left 2 partition. This one is, let's suppose, right 1 partition. And this one is, let's suppose, right 2 partition. Now, how we get this? So simple is, now you can see we have 3. And in indexing we have 0, 1. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2 and this is 3. So we are pointing to that one, but the left one is 8. So we can say that the left one partition is what? The cut one value is 3. So we can say the cut one value minus 1. So eventually we get 2 and we want left 2. You can see we have cut 2 value as 2, but you can see the left 2 value is 3. So if we are at present at 2, so to getting 3 we can do minus 1. Simple as that. So we can do cut 2 minus 1 and we are getting what? 2 minus 1 is 1. So these are the index value. Similarly, what is the right 1 and what is the right 2? So simple as that. You can see this is 10 and this is 6. So the cut 1 is 3 and the cut 2 is 2. In that case, So this is indexing as 0, 1 and 2. So the cut one is 3 and it contains 3 value. So the right one should be cut 1 and the right 2 should be 6, which is 2, which is cut 2. Okay. So you can see the cut 2 value as 2 and cut 1 value as 3. So we can simply take right 1 as 3, which is the cut 1, and the right 2 value as 2, which is the cut 2. So these are the 4 things that we have, and from there we can simply check these conditions. What we have to check, let's write there. So we have to check, every time we have to check condition that the left one cross check means we have to cross check with right 2, and the left 2 should be less than the right 1. That is what the cross check means. So this is the left 1, it should be less than right 2, and this is the left 2, which should be less than right 1. Now that much part is clear. Now the thing which is more important after that is, if it is not, then what we have to do. So the simple thing is that in that set we want everything minimum and in that set we want everything maximum, and if we get something at this position is maximum and something at this position is minimum, that's why this condition gets false, right? So we can simply do one thing, that we want minimum, so this 6 can be take to that way, like this 6 can be part of the left side and this 8 can be part of the right side. So the number of elements here also remains 5, and after taking this, the number of elements also take 5, because we add one element to it and remove one element to it. So we don't have to think that it is 5 5 or it is equal, it should be equal. Okay, and similar for the case, let's suppose in that set if we have a maximum value and in that set we have a minimum value, what we do, we simply do one thing, the maximum value should be go there and the minimum value should be go there. Now how we can take this? Here we are using some concept of a binary search. Like you know very well that in order to create these cuts, okay, left cut 1 and cut 2, we have a low value and we have a high value. What is that? I will tell you. See, the low is 0 and high is the size of the first array. So initially when we do the first iteration, the low is at the 0th position and the high is at the last position. Now we get one thing, that we do one that partition according to this low high value, but after checking we come to know this, that this 8 is maximum and this 8 should be there, okay, and this 6 should be there. So our partition looks like something, let me change the color, this color. Okay, so what does that mean? The partition will like this. It means we don't have to take it, we have to take 1 5, and from their side we have to take only this one. It means this high that we have there, it should not be there because it is of no use, right? So at that position what we do, we simply make our high as cut. So high comes to there because we have to work on these two things and not on this part. Okay, if you not get it, just think for that, visualize it, or just run for some test cases and you get it. Okay, so now the high is becoming the cut 1 minus 1. Okay, and in that case, if let's suppose this one is greater than that, in that case we simply have to check for this part. In that case the low is becoming the cut 1 plus 1. Mm-hmm. So I know very well that it is not easy that you get in a one time. Okay, you have to dry run this for different test cases and then you get it. Okay, so but this is the main thing, that if there is something which is maximum, there is something which is minimum, so the minimum should go there and maximum should go there, and in order to make partition like this, we have to make our indexes value like this. Yeah, and that is what we have. And and when this condition satisfies, which is where I write it, this one. And if these two conditions are satisfied, so what we do? We check if the n1 plus n2 size is even. So if it is even, what does that mean? That mean we have to take the maximum of these two and minimum of these two. So add these two together and divided by 2. Similar as that, like in that case 6 and 7. So we add this and divided by 2. And let's suppose if it is odd, we simply have to take the minimum value from the right one and right two, from the right one and right two, because the extra element is present in the right part, not in the left part. Okay, so let's see the code. So this is the code actually, and we do the same thing. What we do? One more thing that I want to add is, in that case I will take the maximum like this. So if let's suppose there are two arrays, and if one array has less size, so we have to like, as you can see, there is a low and a high. So the high value should always belong to the element which having size less, right? So we will check if the length of num1 is greater than num2, so we have to call this array. But in that case, the first array is num2 and the second array is num1. Otherwise, we have the size of first array, we have the size of second array. Now we have low and high, as you can see here. And this is a totally a binary search. We will do this until and unless the low should be less than is equal to the high. Okay. Now we are getting the cut one. How we get the cut one? So whatever the size of the array one, we divide it by 2. So let's suppose half of the array is becoming the part of this cut one. Okay. And the cut two should be like the total element is 10. We divided it by 2, we are getting 5. So it means we want 5 elements, but we already take this cut one elements. Okay. So we minus this, and whatever the remaining elements we need, we just take it as a cut two. Similar. Now there is another conditions. Let's suppose if the cut one is 0, it actually means that we have no element present at that side. So we are taking a very minimum value for that, so that our logic should work. Okay. Similarly, if our cut two is 0, understand it carefully. Okay. If our cut two is 0, it actually means we have nothing there. So we are taking the minimum element, so that our code will work. And if it is not, so the left one is cut minus 1, similar to the thing that I will tell you there. So the left one is cut 1 minus 1, left 2 is cut 2 minus 1, right 1 is cut 1 and right 2 is cut 2. So in right 1 and right 2 there is no change. So there is left 2 cut 2 minus 1, right 1 has cut 1, right 2 has cut 2, and there is a maximum size, there is a maximum size. Okay, I think this should clear what it is. It actually means that we have nothing at the right side. Okay, in that case we are taking a maximum value, so that our code works. And we are checking for these two conditions. Okay, if the left one is greater than right two, as I tell you that if it is greater than that one, so our high value should change. Similar, the high is becoming cut minus 1. You can see there. So you can see this part actually. If this one is greater than that, so the high value should become the cut minus 1. That is there. And in the vice versa case, we have cut plus 1. And if these two conditions, let's suppose, is not there, it means that these two conditions are satisfied. Now we simply check if the array is of size even, we have to take the maximum, we have to take the minimum. okay, and we have to divide it. What I do here, let's suppose on adding these two, we are getting some value as, let's suppose 5. In that case, we have to do 5 by 2. Sorry, in that case, we have to do 5 by 2, right? Because the answer is 2.5, okay? But let's suppose in adding these two, we are getting 6. So in that case, according to this problem, we don't want any decimal. That's why we do the integer division of Python, okay? And if there is an odd element, so as I said, we have to take the minimum from the right one and right two. And let's suppose if there is nothing as a median present here, so we have to give 0.0. So let's submit it, and it is fine. Okay, thank you, bye bye.